I love my husband. I laugh at his jokes. I think he's fantastic. And then all day, every day, I want to punch him in his dumb face. And it's not the big things that make you want to kill your spouse. It's little stuff. Little stuff. Like, why does he have to ask me where everything is? All the time. In his own goddamn house. Like, I'm Carson the butler, and we live in Downton Abbey or something. All day, on a loop. Where are the keys? Where's the dog? Where's the garage? When we got married, we were so poor, we lived in a studio apartment. A studio apartment. And he had the nerve to ask me where stuff was. Where's the spatula? I'm like, motherfucker. Everything we own is out. Like, what? How lazy are you? But I don't nag, don't nag. It falls on deaf ears. Do what I do. Use positive reinforcement. Positive, like Caesar Milan. I use calm, assertive energies. I am the buck leader. So when I see the behavior I'd like to see more of, I encourage it. I'll see him doing something, I'll get up behind him, I'll be like, oh, oh yeah. Mmm, you loading up that dishwasher. Oh, you know clean dishes make me want to suck stuff. But don't say that unless you mean it, because they'll come looking for payment quick. And then you got to be like, no, or whatever, that's stupid. Well, no, because there's a small window where a woman will do that. You know what I mean? Like, in the beginning of the relationship, that's the best for a guy. That's blowjob season. In the beginning, we're so thrilled to be there, we'll blow you for anything. You got me tickets to the comedy show? Six-piece McNuggets. You open the car door for me. And then you get married and it's like, honeymoon blowjob. No, we stopped serving that yesterday. Yeah, that ain't on the menu anymore, my man. You better get that while the getting's good. But you gotta do that stuff, you know, you gotta, oh, I love it. Well, you have to, man. I don't wanna be single. Are you kidding me? No way, not in this era, uh-uh. No way, because women, you know, we can't just get all old and fat like in the good old days, you know? Like now we gotta maintain our fuckability at every era of our lives. It's exhausting. You know, Kathy Bates is an amazing actress because she kinda has to be. You know what I mean? Like you turn 30, you pump out a kid, and now they call you MILF. 40, and now I'm a cougar. And then you're a grandma, and you're like, oh, sweet, I'm out of the system. No, you ain't. Now they call you a gilf. A grandma I'd like to... No, not Nana. Not sweet butterscotch candy giving Nana, no! And here's the thing that's whack. There's nothing for dudes, right? They don't call you guys animal names or acronyms. They don't call you guys DILFs. Well, it's true, you know, because there's no such thing as a dad you want to fuck. Well, no, I know this because I've been in the airports in the Midwest and I have seen the dads. Oh, I've seen you dads. Really, Dad? You think some woman is gonna be like, oh, yeah. Dad, oh. I love those faded blue jeans you got on. Mm-mm. Oh, is that a brown braided belt? How do you keep those white New Balance sneakers so white, Dad? Oh, is that a phone holster? Ring, ring, official dad business. Oh, Dad, I love the clever way you kept those glasses on your head with that rope. But what always gets me, Dads, it's always in the jeans. Oh, it's always in those jeans. Because they're always so high. And so tight. They're so high and tight. Woo!